What's up, y'all? It's your girl HT, and I'm back with another video. That's what it is. I'm gonna react to JiDion's video where he went to the most racist town in America. Now, a little bit of a backstory of this reaction is when I did the reaction to Nico's, it was like I reacted to the most racist man in America. People were telling me and DMing me that JiDion, who is in the video, if you watch the video, go ahead and watch the video, but when you watch the video, you're gonna see there's only one other black guy that you run into, that Nico runs into in the video. And apparently that's JiDion. So I found out that JiDion was doing the exact same video. It's freakishly weird, I think, but hey, everything happens for a reason. But he did his video, I guess they were there at the same time. And I don't know if they know each other. From what I knew, that they didn't plan this. They just went and both did the same concept in the same city. And this is JiDion's version. This one has 7 million views. So it's up there as well. And so I never watched it. Someone sent me the link. So I was like, okay, let me save this. And when I have a moment, let me react. So today's May 2/4 weekend, and I was only about to go to my parents' house to do a barbecue, and my son was acting up, so I was gonna take him early, but then he just fell asleep in his stroller, so I left him there, and I'm here to react for this video. Go ahead and subscribe, like, and comment this video, and turn your post notifications on, because that's when you know when I post next. So you already know, I got my Starbucks, I make my own coffee and put it in a Starbucks cup, so I look bougie. Let's get into this video. All right.
Several years ago, Harrison, Arkansas received the moniker of the most racist town in America.
Home of this KKK compound and Tom Robb.
That hatred is here and we still don't tolerate it.
I think if they want to start trouble, they should do it in their own town. We didn't ask for them.
So I was scrolling through YouTube the other night and I saw a video that caught my attention. It was called Holding a Black Lives Matter Sign in America's Most Racist Town.
This right here is the biggest hoax there ever was.
It's the next thing to ask.
It is. It's
bad downtown.
Inside this 2-minute video was a sneak peek of how the residents
that video is so dumb
saw behavior, and they were shown cussing at and berating a white man for doing nothing more than holding a Black Lives Matter sign.
And I have black friends, so F you, what the hell.
So I thought to myself, not only as a content creator, but also as a black man, I have to go to this town and find out firsthand the truth about the most racist town.
So this guy is just like Nico, and I'm gonna plug in the link to the reaction I did to Nico's video. But these guys, JiDion is the type of person like Nico, where like you see, oh, this is the most racist town. They're racist to me. Let me go there and piss them off. I feel like these guys, they're like the type of guys, like I said in the other video, where they're the type of guys in high school where they just do the things that you would never do and they get away with it. And they make the best out of it too. Like, it's actually hilarious. But all right, go to the town then.
All right, so we survived one night here already. I'm not gonna lie, it's really not that bad so far. Like, literally everybody I've talked to, they've been really nice.
You're responsible
about that. Bro, chill. Girls literally DM me talking about, can you please give me some of it? Like, you don't need it.
You're like a freight train of urban excellence.
Oh, yeah. Hello, everybody. As you guys can honestly tell, we're not from here.
That's all right. I love the Killing Me Softly background music. It's...
I'm from Atlanta, you know. I'm one of the best rappers coming out of there and everything like that.
So I want to let you guys know too, I don't know nothing about JiDion. I think I've heard of him a couple of times in the YouTube world, but I don't really know anything of him. I don't think I've seen any videos where JiDion is in, but I've heard of him and like I've seen his thumbnails and stuff. So that's my background of JiDion. But I guess he's from Atlanta.
But we've heard rumors that this is the most racist town in America, but so far, I'm not gonna lie, it's been like one of the nicest places. Actually, let's go with boot. My booty's kind of hurting, so I need more cushioning.
Yeah. Facts.
I'm not gonna lie, they're not really like fitting our narrative.
You're like, man, it's the coolest town in America.
Hey, can I ask you a question? How long have you lived here?
16 years.
16 years. Wow. Like, how do you like it?
I like it.
They said that this place was like the most racist town in America, yeah. But like, what have you seen here that you would like deem maybe racist?
Out in Zeke, which is probably like a 20-minute drive, the leader of the Ku Klux Klan or whatever lives out there.
So this isn't the racist town, Zeke.
We have people, of course, but you're gonna find that everywhere.
Sure. From all places, right
here.
Bro,
I mean, everybody's saying that this is the most like racist town in America. Yeah,
supposedly it is.
But it's been like chill. Like,
it is chill. I love it here, actually.
Hey, this is not made up. The KKK, he savors with their fucking leader.
Yeah. Really? And me, did they like beat my ass if I like showed up?
Nah, they don't.
I don't know. Like, I heard stories.
So he's a current leader.
Yeah.
And he's cool people.
I met him, he's pretty cool, but.
This is the man we need to find, y'all. Guys, when I tell you, we came to this
so town, that guy lives in Zing.
Preparation. We just came here expecting racism to come to us, but we're gonna have to go to racism.
Should they just bait people?
Yeah, I know about some fucking black guy. And then
you just have a whole family.
Hey, guys.
That'd be so funny.
That would. Bro, you might have connections to White Pride Radio. Like,
oh, yeah. We gotta kick some bars on White Pride Radio.
Alright boys, so Brandon literally got food poisoning while we were inside the place and stuff like that. Brody actually like started throwing up like crazy.
Oh my god.
So he's gonna be in this
food
hotel.
Food poisoning's the worst.
So I was thinking about going to Zinc. Would that be a bad idea? I'm trying to do an interview with Rob Tom. So be careful. It's that bad. For real? That's what I'm saying, like, cause like the adventure? Go to Zinc? You too. Thank you guys. Do you think it'll be dangerous if we go to Zinc?
Probably not. Everybody just kind of tries to stay away from them, so people don't really have information on them. Their mindset is on trying to keep, you know, it kind of whitewashed here.
Yeah.
You know, I want more people to just get out of the hood in general.
Alright boys, man, so right now we don't have any leads on how we can get over to Zinc. So we're trying to see if we can find anybody that knows any people over there. So that way, like, we won't really be coming unannounced and stuff like that. I'm not gonna lie, that would be, like, really cool if we could get, like, an interview with the leader of the KKK. Isn't it crazy how, like, we went to the most racist town in America, but we're, like, looking for the racism? Oh, I know that was a Confederate flag, but it's just the Arkansas flag. I was like, never mind. We found it.
Who in here knows Tom Robb? I need to talk to him. Got some business to handle. I don't like racism.
Excuse me, ma'am. Do you know Tom Robb by any chance?
No, I
do not. You don't? Do you guys know who Tom Robb is?
The fact that, okay, so I'm guessing they only have one Walmart in this place. Or, I don't know, because this Walmart does seem like the same Walmart that Nico went to. But it's just funny to me, like, I guess it's small town, but they're literally, like, going around looking for this guy. Which, I guess, like, works out in a small town. I don't know if, like, big city, if you're able to just, like, find the person that you're looking for and then just go find them in that day or whatever, in the weekend. This is interesting. I wonder if he actually interviews that guy, the KKK leader.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry. This is what journalism is. You have to find the scoop.
Right? Yeah.
Do you know anybody that lives in Zinc? You don't? I'm trying to have an interview with the leader of the KKK, Tom Robb. Looking for
more
have to go out
for. That
attention,
guy looks like he's a Walmart. Yo, doesn't that white guy I think he was in the technology department, didn't he look like he was high as hell? I swear, he's just like, good luck with that. So uninterested.
I am trying to conduct an interview with Tom Robb. Does anybody know Tom Robb by any chance? Raise your hand if you might know Tom Robb. No? Do you guys know Tom Robb? Yeah. How you doing?
That's crazy. Do you knew him?
Yes, sir.
I grew up with both of his sons.
Oh, you did?
Yes.
Okay.
Don't use my name. You know how gangs are?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like, if you call somebody out in your own hometown?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But what do you want them to know?
I don't know. We're not trying to know anything. Like, we just, like, me personally.
He won't give you my
name. You don't think he will?
Brother, I could tell you some story. How we used to have to cut the tails of black people when they were born.
So do they have a lot of pull in this area?
That's what we
call
back.
Sorry, wait, what? They used to cut the tails off black people? I'm gonna need an explanation. Comment down below if you guys understand what that means, because I don't understand what that means.
You see, right now, me doing this, I'm a sellout. I'm to the Hill Club. To the people around here, he's losing his cool. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
He was the edge game. And they're also starting to step out for once.
I've been around here, like, but I haven't seen nothing but nice people.
The only reason I come up is because you got balls.
Oh, for asking that?
Yeah.
Yeah, he does have balls.
No, I'm not going there to change his mind, you know? Like, he grew up believing what he believes.
So they have a church. If you read your Bible, he was created by God shaping him out of clay and breathing breath in his nostrils.
Yes, sir.
That's the wild man. You are concerned. He's no different than a cow. Nothing worse.
So they preached that like we were.
Yes.
Oh my God.
I'm good, man. Y'all watch the vids?
Yes, bro.
Appreciate y'all boys, man. Appreciate y'all boys.
Am I still here talking like some superstar and don't even damn know?
I do YouTube.
Do you know how to get there? I ain't gonna see you because I don't afraid to get hurt.
I don't know. I feel like I'm pretty charismatic.
He said, I'm standing beside a superstar and I don't even know it. You just called the man. You just said that his color is because bro, I can't even say it. How are you gonna call this, say that black people are cows and beasts and stuff like that, but then you're like dapping them up and stuff? Because in my mind, this guy he's talking to is racist. In my mind, the guy he's talking to is racist.
Guy, like, hey guys, I was good with y'all boys.
This is crazy, bro.
How long y'all been living out here, bro?
My whole life.
Trying to have an interview with Tom Robb.
Yeah, we can take him to him.
I mean, y'all could take me to him, but like, I gotta figure out if he'll wanna have me.
We know where like his church is, so.
For real.
Yeah, he's got a church out in Zim.
Do you guys have Snapchat?
Yeah.
All right, here, can you do me a favor? Could you go up there, kind of like tell them all about me? I'm not gonna spin the story or nothing.
Right.
I just wanna have an interview, just talk. But if you gotta get this interview going, you're legends.
Oh, we'll get it for you.
Well, you
hold on. I just want to see. He did this. He posted this May 6th. So he posted this before Nico did. Because Nico, I know, posted it May 13th.
I'm playing. Shit, bro. Flex on me, bro. Be like, bro, he got 4.6.
So because he posted this early, I'm guessing that JiDion got to the KKK leader first. I forget his name. What did it say? Tom Robb? Which Tom Robb is such a weird name, isn't it? It's not like two first names. How is your name like Thomas Robert or Tom Robb? Like, wouldn't it be just be one? I don't know, whatever, white people. But I think this guy's probably gonna interview him just because I thought if it's after Nico, then he probably would say no, but if it's before Nico, he might say yes and then just say yes again because he's stupid.
6 million subscribers. The next biggest thing, he identifies as a white man. That's crazy, y'all. Like, Brody literally like pulled me aside to like warn me. He's like, bro, you got balls saying that. Because when I tell you, this man was like nervous looking around and there was people like staring at us that are like a part of it. But, bro, like, I feel like we ruffled some feathers already.
I feel like Jidian's a little nervous.
Alright, so a little bit of searching and everything and a little bit of driving, we found it. The infamous sign, whiteprideradio.com. It can't be racist because they have a puppy on it. So, like, that's some good reverse
It's
psychology.
Not racist
and
to look
Tom Robb's
people, right. White Pride.
So, like, what radio. Even is White Pride Radio? You're tuning into White Pride Radio. White is right. White Pride Radio. I'm not white, so I can't do it. That's why I was coughing. Are you black? Do you have 4.6 million subscribers? Does every video you do, you wear a do-rag to hide the fact that you have a clapped hairline, but all your millions of viewers know that you have a clapped hairline, and you brush it off like it's a joke, but really you're insecure about it?
Hey, man!
Then you need Keeps.
Keeps
is a subscription service that helps men keep their hair. They offer clinically proven treatments to combat the symptoms of hair loss.
Hey, there ain't nothing wrong with being bald. I don't know. I feel like I'm on the wrong side of the argument when it comes to men being bald, especially black men. I just find it so handsome. Like, I don't know. I kind of grew up like seeing Montel Williams and like Steve Harvey when he shaved off the high top fade. I don't know. I like the bald look. Like, I feel like you really get to see the man's face, and especially if he has facial hair, the bald look, which a lot of bald men have facial hair. So, I don't know. I'm kind of not into the whole like trying to keep your hair. I always just say shave it off and like get an elite buzz, like an elite hair system where like you can buzz it and it looks fresh all the time and you can just line up your beard and stuff. Plus it saves you guys money. Like you don't have to get haircuts every 2 weeks. I don't know. I just feel like if you're balding, God is choosing you to be bald and just allow it.
Some of the things that keeps ahead of the competition is all their plans are affordable, typically half the cost of pharmacy prices. All treatment plans are personalized and doctor recommended. And if you have any issue, they have 24/7 expert support with a year of unlimited.
Wait, is this real or is this a joke?
The doctor message. Worried about your friends figuring out that you're trying to make a 3-1 comeback on your hairline loss? Don't even sweat it. All treatments are delivered straight to the customer's house. You don't even gotta worry about that, going to the store or anything. It comes straight to you. And one of the high satisfaction rates, results are proven within 6 months of starting the treatment. Hair loss stops with Keeps. To get 50% off your first order, go to keeps.com/rawdog or click the link in my description. That's capital KEEPS.com/rawdog.
I know. Shout out to Keeps. Let's make this 3-1 comeback.
What a joke. Okay, I'm not sure if that was a real ad, but that's freaking hilarious. I feel like it was real. Comment down below if Keeps is a real company, guys, because. And just love your bald hair, bro. Just love it.
Let us know what's going on with Tom. We're going to check up on Brandon.
The sun finally came out.
Housekeeping. Yo, you feel better? No, you don't.
I don't know, I'm like crazy.
Still?
Yeah.
Yo, Walker, so tell me everything that happened when you went up there.
We went this long dirt road, right? We had no service. We went up to his house where he was at, and he had this dude out there. We asked if we could see Tom, see if Tom was here, right?
Yeah.
He didn't say a word. Like, okay, and he went to the house, and he got Tom. He was like, would you have time for a meeting? And Tom was like, I don't have time. He's like, what are we talking about? He was like, not because he's African American or something like that. Like, he said that.
at least he's not racist.
Yeah, he is.
Oh, okay. So these are the kids at Walmart that he went and he... These guys... It must be small town things because people got time to like go. I don't know if I could walk around the city and be like, hey, can you like go 20 minutes from here and like check if I can go here? I think everyone would literally be like, fuck you, girl. What the hell? Fuck you. Go figure it out yourself.
And he's like, maybe next week or like, what's the time schedule? And I was like, dang.
So I'm pretty sure a lot of your guys from your school know that I'm in town and stuff like that.
Right.
What if y'all and y'all friends come by, scoop me up, and we go drive up there together? How fast can you get this all set up? Let's do it. Let's do it. If Tom can't make time for me, I will make time for Tom.
Can we just go back a couple of seconds? Can you guys see this man here? The way they plan their videos is actually hilarious. Like, everything is just, I feel like they do to kind of be funny. And this guy right here, I just noticed him just before the scene switched.
All set up.
Hilarious. I think he's a sick guy.
Let's do it. Let's do it. If Tom can't make time for me, I will make time for Tom.
How are these
motherfuckers
still operating, bro?
They ain't a good publicist, bro. Bro, I'm gonna be part of their marketing team, bro. I would have a KKK pop and PRDX KKK. That would be a nice collab. Bro, the trash talk would be wild in the game lobbies.
So is JiDion's brand Raw Dog? Is that what it is?
Alright, boys, I'm about to meet my army. I'm not gonna lie. I don't know what I started, but pretty excited. It's crazy, like, the power that I have as a creator. Like, I only think of myself as a YouTuber, but I'm literally bringing people out with me to go visit the KKK. Like, if you were to tell me I was gonna do that back when I was in high school making videos, I'm not gonna lie, I probably wouldn't believe you. You gotta tell your parents what you guys are doing, right?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Alright, they told their parents, so don't get mad at me. Mom, I'm going to the KKK headquarters right now. Mom, it's bigger than black and white. I love you, Mom. All right, Mom, I'm sorry. I'm about to make the grand wizard. I gotta go. This the game? This the game? We're gonna have a meeting. I know you guys.
Ew, the window is so dirty.
Everything like that, but this is not no joking matter. We're gonna let them know it's bigger than black and white. Marquez Brownlee on me. Marquez Brownlee on three. 1, 2, 3. Let's go.
I actually like that truck though, I won't lie. I want to get a truck like that one day. Like a big truck with big rims, you know?
We got some people right here. Hello, how you doing? I was trying to see if Mr. Rob was maybe here. I'm a YouTuber. My name is JiDion. I was just wondering if like we could have like maybe like a little dialogue with...
Is this guy like his doorman or is that like one of his sons or something? Because he was in the other video too. Does he just like work on his land? And he'd be wearing the same clothes too. I swear he wore the same outfit in another video.
Mr. Rob, if he has any free time and stuff like that.
Right now he's getting different stuff together for the conference that's coming up, so...
I heard about that. What can I ask what that conference is about?
Faith and freedom.
I don't know if there's any way maybe I could come. No.
Especially not.
I'm dead.
Paranoia some people have.
Man, we are anarchists, are we?
He said, mm.
It's America, you know? You got the First Amendment, you know, freedom of speech and everything like that.
Actually, I don't believe in that because if you have someone who can lose their job and their ability to support their family that they love, where they might have been brave enough to speak up, they won't put their children and their wife at risk.
So do you feel like here the truth is spoken?
I would say as much as can be.
From the videos I've seen online and stuff like that, I'm sure you've seen them. Yeah. You know, I was expecting them just like, you know, step right foot into town and then call the N-word, but...
If it would make you feel better, I'll try it for you.
Oh, man. I just kept on hearing people, they were like, nah, the racists aren't
innocent. Crazy.
They're over in zinc.
That's crazy that he felt confident to say that.
And then they were talking about how like they like kind of kicked you guys out of Harrison.
No white person, for the most part, moves to seek out diversity. They'll give lip service to it and move as far away as possible from it. Put up gated communities, spend their money.
Me personally, like, I agree to a certain extent and stuff like that, you know. As black people, you know, we look out for each other, you know. It's like, you know, people say black power, they look out for black businesses and stuff like that.
I'm not a segregationist, I'm a separationist. Every white country, and only white countries, are expected to become melting pots of humanity. And that's my stance. I oppose white genocide.
I'm not here to change anybody's mind or nothing. Like I said, like, that's why I just wanted, like, I feel like the conversation should always be had. Because I feel like for there to be improvement into the future, you have to hear something different than your own opinion.
I often get an assumption made by me, and they wonder if black people did something bad to me. White people have done something bad to me, and I don't hate them either.
Yeah.
But it's never about that. It's I have a certain set of beliefs.
I wasn't expecting to come here and have, like, the civil, you know, conversation.
But your beliefs are racist. Your beliefs are prejudiced to a group of people. We're all people. Yeah.
Weird. Conversation like this, but I came here with the heart to come with that. And I appreciate you coming out with the heart to have that same conversation with us, you know?
I have one question. So, is there anything you want to say to the people out there about Harrison, Arkansas, or Zinc Road, or that all they know is that it's the most racist town?
Well, I sort of like that designation.
Yeah, you see what I mean? He's racist. He's trying to say he's not racist, but he's actually racist. Because, like, just because you can stand in front of a black man and tell him that you believe this, this, this without saying the N-word, you're still racist. So the fact that he's trying to entertain this conversation and make it seem like he's not racist, but then he's saying, like, oh, I like that we're known as the most racist town in America or whatever, like, weirdo.
Rock with it. He's fucking with it.
Most racist town in America. And I was wondering if there's any way like we could have a future conversation.
I don't know how these men can stand in front of these people with their game.
Church. Or maybe I can even attend
out of shape.
A church service.
No. It is a racial church.
Oh.
It is an offshoot of Israeli identity.
Usually, you know, some people that find themselves racial, they don't like Jews and stuff like that. So that's kind of like shocking to hear.
Well, we're not Jewish. Jews is not the chosen people. that the white race is.
Do you have anything to say to the boys?
If you ever wondered if you were stupid, just know there are stupider people in the world than you. Just always know that. Like, whenever you're doubting yourself and just like, damn, I'm so stupid, you made a mistake that you've probably done multiple times or whatever, just know. There is stupider people in the world than you. By far, this man has to be, in my mind, and men like him, this whole church, all of them that go to this church, including obviously the head leader, but all of them, the families, all of these people are probably one of the stupidest people I've heard of. I mean, there's a lot of stupid people in the world, but these guys are definitely up there in the triangle, bro.
There's girls out there.
Oh, thanks for listening.
Appreciate you guys for tuning in. Oh, also, is it bigger than Black and White?
Yeah. What effects one will eventually poison the other?
It is bigger than Black and White. All right, thank you for your time.
All right.
That was something. Damn, so, you gonna throw up on their property? Damn. Brandon's saying, that's how much Brandon hates racism. He pukes at it.
I can't stand
it. Makes him sick to his stomach.
Yeah, that must be embarrassing.
So basically, the local administration, they heard that I was in town and they wanted me to come to the high school. And so, yeah, I'm come say what's up to them. Hello.
Aww.
My first brother.
Aw, this is cute. I like this.
For the quote unquote most racist town, this is the town I've gotten the most love from. And I just want to say, I truly appreciate it.
We're literally about to have a meeting with the mayor of Harrison. Like, it's actually crazy as hell. Brandon was able to get it. Like, so I'm not gonna lie. Like, I'm really nervous and everything. But
what are you wearing, JiDion?
Oh, my bad,
man. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm like...
yeah. So that's the clip I saw in Nico's thing. But it was flipped. It was Nico, like, oh, let me go back and see that. Hold up.
Everything. But I think I'm gonna kill it. I think I'm gonna do my thing. Oh, my bad, man. Yeah, I'm like really nervous. Like, I'm literally about to be the mayor, but you know what?
Are you the mayor?
Did they know each other? Like, I wonder if they both knew that they were YouTubers. It was interesting. But yeah, that's what I heard. I heard that JiDion was going to the same hotel, that Hotel Seville, which is where Nico was staying, to interview the mayor.
I am. Oh, it's nice to meet you. What's your name?
I am Jackson.
Mr. Jackson, nice to meet you.
What's your name?
DeMarcus Cousins.
DeMarcus Cousins.
I go by JiDion.
What do you expect?
Like, you see the videos and stuff like that, you know, it's like racism and everything, but ever since I stepped foot on this land, like, I've been getting nothing.
Hold on, my baby's crying.
Okay. Just let mommy finish her video, all right? Be a good baby. You be a good baby. Yeah? Okay. You could see me, you good? All right, y'all. I really hope that my baby will let me watch this last 3 minutes, please. Okay, he's right here. I don't know if you guys can see him. You wanna be in the video? You wanna be in the video? Huh. You guys can see like a corner of his face. Okay, be good, baby. Okay, so let me finish, 3 minutes.
I'm alone.
You know that video? What do you expect? What's your name?
DeMarcus Cousins.
DeMarcus Cousins.
I go by JiDion.
What'd you expect?
Like, you see the videos and stuff like that, you know, you expect racism and everything, but ever since I stepped foot on this land, like, I've been getting nothing but love.
I know. You know, that video is one of the biggest lies that ever happened. They took advantage of a town that had that perception because of another lie.
No, and the goal was to come here and not try to antagonize, talking about, do you support Black Lives Matter? It was literally just to come here and just say, hello, how's your day going? We might have different viewpoints on religion or politics and everything like that, but at the end of the day, you and me lead the same.
Absolutely.
We're both human beings, and I can honestly say everybody in this town has treated me like a human being.
You know, you might be doing something for us that we have been trying to find for 40 years. This is not going to be a prank.
No prank. I just got dressed up.
Okay, good.
The first thing I want to ask is,
what do you think
about that connotation of Harrison being the most racist town in America?
You know, it just boils my blood because I know the truth.
You know what's crazy? Since I got here, I feel like it was very evident. Like, everybody here that I've met, they made a distinction. They said it's not Harrison. They're all over at Zinc.
Okay.
I just want to mention, because I'm a Virgo and I see these things. Look, guys.
Everybody here that I've met, they made a distinction. They said it's not Harrison. They're all over at Zinc.
It's not It's not Zoom, people.
Look how he spelled either. It's either E-I-T-H-E-R or E-A-T-H-E-R. It's not E-A-I. Sorry, JiDion, but that's wrong. Right, Ken? That's wrong.
Okay.
They're not racist people. You have one family out there. He happens to live there.
Okay. Mm. Do you feel like these videos have hindered that? Like, have you seen people move?
That video has just done us a lot of harm. Our office was just bombarded, and it just devastated Christine and us. She came in here crying one day because of the hate calls. And, you know, the problem is, you know, the Bob families, they're going to move on sometime. But this video is going to be out there forever.
Yeah. I'm not going to lie. When I did come here and stuff like that, you know, hearing that it's the most racist town in America, I was just, you know, going on expecting it, like, you know, the racism and stuff like that. Making a video, you know, like, oh man, this is what happened to me. But as I got here, I realized, I said, I cannot put that connotation on this town because I am not experiencing that, you know? I got some looks and stuff like that, but I've not gotten anybody say anything. I've gotten a lot of love, people. I had actually a fan invite me over to his house for family dinner. Mm-hmm. We weren't able to make it, but.
You come to my house tonight and spend the night.
Oh man, I wish we could, but yeah. we gotta fly out, but.
What's your last name, man?
Adam.
Cam, I can't hear the video. Please? What did he say? What's your last name? What?
Spend the night.
Oh, man, I wish we could, but yeah. we gotta fly out, but.
What's your last name? Maybe
Adam. I don't know about all that. That'd be cool, but.
No, I mean, really, we need help. We need something, and you've got a reach that we don't have. God, you could do this.
I have to ask, with the, you know, the white pride radio sign, how come, especially with you being the mayor, like, maybe, like, why wouldn't you be able to take that down?
Yeah.
I'm so glad you asked.
Yeah.
Four of them. When the first one went up, it was worse. I had a personal campaign to get that taken down, and I was able to do that. This last one is on his property. Legally, we can't do it. It's First Amendment.
Well, Mr. Mayor, man, I appreciate you so much.
You're welcome, sir. You're a pretty cool guy. I didn't know that.
I tried my best, but not as cool as you, though.
I didn't see anybody want a picture with me.
That's what I'm saying. You have the man right here. You don't want a picture.
I don't even smoke weed, but I feel high when I'm next to you, babe. Used to be my girl. Used to be my boo thing. Now I'm telling everybody you my boo thing. You my boo thing.
Is it bigger than black and white?
Yeah.
Wow. Well. This is another video that probably boiled my blood. I
Donald
won't even lie.
Trump.
There's another video that boiled my blood. I'm gonna like this video though. Let me just go back.
Strumming my pain with his feet.
I'll like this video. And I'm gonna subscribe to JiDion. He seems hilarious. One question though I have for JiDion. Y'all answer this for me. So since you're a professional raw dogger, how many kids do you got? Because that sounds like cap to me. Unless you got a lot of kids. And from my own experience, I can just tell you it brings kids. So, yeah, I just want to know how many kids you got. Because you got zero kids. How are you a professional wild dogger? I just want to know. Unless you're like professional pulling out game too or something like that. Anyways, shout out to JiDion. That was hilarious. I mean, these people, I don't think I need to see another video of them. They're clearly the stupidest people I've ever heard of. Sucks that the mayor can't really do more about it. But I definitely would never live in a town or a city like that. Like, if where I'm from turned into, like, the most racist place ever, I would literally pack my stuff and dip to somewhere else. But anyways, DeMarcus did a good job, you know, JiDion. I wonder what JiDion's, why he names himself JiDion, because, yeah, I want to know. That's interesting. So that wraps up my reaction to this video. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. Comment down below what you think. And also check out the reaction I did to Nico's video. I saw that first. Till the next video. It is what it is. Bye.